Okay, so yesterday we have seen creating waveforms for actuals. We have created asymmetric, symmetric and composite waveforms. So today we will create a waveform for budget related waveforms. So I am going to manage data forms. So I need a new folder. So selecting forms, I will select create and I will give some name called as budget. Say for budgeting purpose I am creating a waveform and say okay. So now my folder got created, budget folder got created, and now I want to create a symmetrical form. So if I want to create a symmetrical form, I'll say create. When I say create, here itself I have to specify what database I have to connect. So once I select this, in future I cannot change this particular database. So expense I have selected. So my data form name is budget, but for all EMs, for all entities, budget for all entities. Okay, let me go into my rows and columns. So in my rows I want accounts and I also want periods. Say from accounts I'll take my expense account, asset account, liability account, equity account and saved assumption account. After selecting this, I'll say submit, and from my period I'll be selecting the remaining periods. Say I'll be selecting all the periods including descendants of. Okay, I want my quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, quarter 4 and all the numbers. So in this, let us remove few accounts. So I don't want to do my equity management and also liability management. Say I want to manage only my expense, assets and saved assumptions. Fine. Now in rows I'll select entity and I'll also select currency. Say from entity I'll select all of my entities: India, US, Canada, Europe. And from currency I'll select both the currencies, local currency and as well as USD currency. Local currency just to see, to input my local currency, local currencies, and USD to have a converted data. I'll say so. So this is the waveform. So in pages or in point of view, in two pages I'll go with years. I'll have many number of years in it. So I'll take all the years that I'm having right now. I'll take descendants of this year. So scenario, because it is a budget related scenario, I'll be selecting only budget. And from version, I'll take bottom up version. Before we have taken target version, now let us take only bottom up version. So remaining things, business rules. So two business rules will be created by default for every webform. One is currency business rule and one is data form related business rule. These are nothing but almost calculation scripts, but these calculation scripts will not be available in your SBS application. They are available from your planning application itself. Okay, and you can set your properties. You can say run on save and save this particular web form. So now I'll open this particular web form, budget web form. So if I open this particular budget waveform, so financial year 08 is blocked. You cannot input numbers into this particular year because your budgeting is starting from which year? From 12. Where you can specify this? You can specify this in your dimensions, and in dimensions you can specify it in your scenario. Okay, in your scenario, if you look on your budget, if I say edit, I'm able to see that my budgeting year is starting from FY12 and at the same time it is ending at FY15 and it is open from month January to December. From month January of year FY12 to the month FY15 December, all these particular columns will be opened. So let us say So let us open our web form back. So now this particular web form should be opened from FY12 and say go. So this web form is opened for your local input only, because USD you cannot input because they are always your converted values, right? Okay. FY12 is open and till FY15 December it will be open. If you see FY15 December it is open. So in between all the months and all the years will be open. See, in case if I select FY16, what happens? Your budgeting year will be closed. So this is how you can set your budgeting year open, and you can close also your budgeting year. You can set the ranges. So now let me take FY12. So whatever data I am going to input in my local should be converted to USD. So for this, what we have to do, before inputting your numbers, I'll go into administration and I'll go into manage exchange rates. So already this particular exchange rate table, it is used for your actuals, but you cannot use it for your budget. So we will create a new thing. So I'll say bud for FY12. This is a budget, this is a table for your FY12. I'll say save. With this, your budget table got created, and I'll say edit. So you know which options to select in this. Because we are not including beginning balance, I'm removing my beginning balance, and I'm also not considering historical values, because all of my accounts are considering, either they are considering average or ending. In which case, your average will be selected whenever your accounts are expense and revenue. My accounts expense or revenue, I say, what option will be selected in your account? By default, average will be selected. And if it is asset, liability and equity, by default, your option will be ending value. So method, you know why we are selecting this. So let me say next. So now I am able to see financial year 08, but we are required to pull it from FY12. So what I'll do is, Canada, as I did yesterday, 1.012, and ending value, it grows some points, 0.013. So if I say fill year, what happens? It will fill only your financial year 12, but I want this values to be filled to 13, 14, 15 also. So instead of that, what I'll do is I'll say fill table. Means this will fill your entire table. Say from FY08 to FY016, everything will be filled. So I'll say fill table. And I'll select this and I'll say fill table. Same ways, I'll come to Euro. So Euro, it will be somewhere around almost like 1.2 times greater than that. Let us think that 1.2, and when it became to ending value, let us say 1.2. So I'll say fill table, fill table. Same way, GBP. Say it will be 1.2 because it will be greater than your Euro. So 1.4. Table. Fill table. Finally, India, I'm just dividing it by. So average value throughout the month, I took an average and it was 55 rupees, but ending it became 57. Let us fill the table. Fill the table. So now you have inputted your exchange rates completely into each and every year. I'll say save. So your exchange rates are saved. Where this exchange rates are saved? This exchange rates are stored into a table called as HSP_exchange_rates. All your exchange rates are stored into a table. Backend there will be some table. In that table, HSP_exchange_rates. Into that table, this particular exchange rates are stored. How will this data be loaded into your SBase database? To load that, what we have to do? First option we have to do is go to dimensions, select scenario dimension, and in that select your budget and select what table you have to select, because you are having two tables already. This actual is being used for your actual reporting, and I can use this budget because we are specifically using only budget for this. Now I'll say save. So with this, your budget has been attached onto your table. Now if I want to push these numbers onto my SBase database, what I have to do? I have to say manage database. After managing my database, I have to select database and I have to say refresh. When I say refresh, in between it will populate, it is updating, populating financial exchange rates. So this is nothing but it is lock and sending your exchange rates into your SBS database. Now your exchange rates are available in your SBS database. Okay. Next thing we need to do is we need to create a currency conversion script. Okay. So this currency conversion is for BUD1. Let us give the calculation script name as BUD1 and I'll say next. So on what currency it has to be converted? It has to be converted to USD currency. Only reporting currencies will be available. I'll say submit. Say from scenario, it is not actuals, but right now we want to convert the data only on your budget. I'll say and we are using bottom up version only. It will display all bottom up version members. In this right now we are having only one bottom up version member. I'll say. When I say save, this will create a calculation script into your SBS database. I'll say save. Okay, this has created your database. Now, instead of going into my SBS database and running those calculation scripts, what I'll do is I'll go to data forms. I'll edit this budget form. I'll go to business rules. And in this, now I'm able to see my calculation script called BUD1. I'll take it to my right hand side. With this, I will also take my bottom up version script also. Okay, and I'll say save. So now, whenever I open this particular web form, I'll be able to see my calculation scripts here. Calculation scripts, business rules, whatever are here. Right now, we are not aware of the business rules. We are going to talk about only calculations. So, first thing is I have to run this BUD1 script. So it said it has run this particular script successfully. Next script, bottom up version script I am going to run. Okay. Next script, I should be running currency and data form related conversions. When I have data, then I have to run this. I'll say close and I'll say okay. Now, let me input some data into this and let us see if this data is converting to your USD currency. So 100, 200. Now I'll say save data. So if you see, your data is getting converted. $1.8. This is 200 rupees. So it is getting converted to $3.6. And on a total, it is becoming 1.6 plus 1. 1.8 plus 3.6, nothing but 5.4. Same way, if I put some data into USD, say $100, $200. And same way, into Canada, 100 Canadian dollars and 200 Canadian dollars. Same way, Euro, 100 euros, 200 euros. Same way, UK, pound, 100 pounds, 200. Now if I say save, so if you see, this 100 is getting replicated as it is, nothing but it is getting multiplied by 1. So you don't see any difference in your US related information. But your Canadian dollar, what is this? It is nothing but 1.01 times greater than your US dollar. So it is showing 1.01.2 US dollars. Europe, it is nothing but 1.2 times greater. So 100 is getting multiplied by 1.2 is nothing but 120, 240, total 360 American dollars. Same as UK dollar, it is 1.3 times multiplied. So 130, 260, 390. So this is how your conversion is taking place. So clear about this? How we converted our data? Simple steps. First, we created a web form. After creating your web form, what we did? We created an exchange rate table. After that, we attach that to a dimension. Which dimension we can attach it? We can attach it to a scenario dimension. And in that, you can attach to a member called as whatever member, actual, budget, forecast. Whichever member you want, you can attach this particular currency. After attaching this particular exchange rate, what you need to do? You need to do a database refresh. After doing this database refresh, you are going to do a calculation currency conversion script. You are going to create a currency conversion. After creating this currency conversion, what we did, we ran those scripts. Only one time we will be running the scripts. Next, when will you run those calculation scripts? Means when you change your exchange rates. When you are changing your exchange rates, After changing this exchange rates, you need to do a database refresh. After doing this database refresh, you have to run your currency conversion script once, and then you have to run your bottom up version script once. If it is bottom, bottom up version. If it is target, target up, target version script will be running for one time. After that, regularly you have to run, whenever you input your data, regularly you have to run currency script first. Currency conversions, whatever are there, from this form point of view. Say this particular addition should take place. For that, which script I have to run? I have to run this currency conversion. And form level value should be summed up. So that is taken care by your data form calculation. Okay, so clear. Now you are clear about this particular data. So your data can be inputted only at local level. They cannot be inputted at USD level. Right? So US local currency is USD. India local currency is INR. Just you can think in such way. All currencies, local is nothing but mentioning that local currency. Okay, now. So this is about your currency conversion. So you are clear about this, right? Inkem problem ledhu kada, currency conversion, exchange rates, and apart from that, your data forms. So asymmetric waveform. How can we create an asymmetric waveform? So I want to create an asymmetric waveform. With account 01, I want January. Account 02, I want, sorry, account 03, I want February. Account 04, I want 06, I want March. These are the values that I want. So how can we do it? So I'll go to manage data forms and select this budget. After selecting this, I'll say edit, and I'll say go to rows. In rows, I'll remove all this because I don't need all these things. I removed all this and I'll take only account 1. So what month I want with account 01? I want January. Okay. Then I'll say add column. After adding this column, I'll select account 3. And from period, I'll be saying February. And say sub. And I'll again add a column, say account 006. This is a saved assumption. With this, I want period March. That's a submit. Now, if I say edit, I'll be able to see all the columns. Okay, return to data form layout. And I'll say save as. Instead of saving it, I'll do a save as all entities for new accounts. So your webform is created. Now let me open this particular webform. If you see, this particular account is opening only for January, this account is opening only for February, and this account is opening only for your March. So if I input my data into this 100, 10, let us see 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. These are the values I have inputted for account 03, but if I input the same numbers for your account 06, 20, 30, 40, 50, and now if I save this, only your account 01 and account 03 data will be converted. Your account 06 data will not be converted. Why means? Do you know why? If you see, this particular data is not getting converted because account 06 is selected as saved assumption. Saved assumptions are not going to be converted. Saved assumptions are used to handle counts mostly. Counts are the number of assets that we have, total number of assets. For that related information, we will be using this saved assumption. So clear about symmetric and asymmetric. Now if I want to combine both of these waveforms, I want to put both of these waveforms. What I can do? I can create a composite data form. From where I can create data form and select budget, I'll say create a composite form. So in this composite form, I want actual data, budget data, and I also want few accounts data. Means I wanted this two account, these two webforms, and I also wanted my actual related webforms into this particular composite form. So how can I create this? So I'll say budget. I wanted this both the things. So I'll select both of them, and I'll go to actuals. Okay, from this I want my actuals for FY20, and I'll say save. Okay. Now let us open this particular web form. So it will open your composite data form. Three web forms will be opened at a time. These two web forms are from your expense database, and this is from your revenue database, because it is a revenue web form. Okay. So this is how we can create your composite data forms. Clear about this? So with this, your web forms are done. Okay. Now my requirements is, I'll go to budget form for few accounts. I want an extra column, extra account called tax. But in tax, if user applies one, it has to calculate my tax. Based on that, you should run calculations. If user applies zero, it should not apply any calculations. This is the requirement. But the basic meaning is, in that cell, you should be either inputting zero or either you should be inputting one. Based on his user inputs, you will be calculating your, you will be performing your calculations using your business rules. But my requirement is, I should see that user should not input any other number other than 1 or 0. 1 kanna 0 gaani, 1 gaani 0 gaani, he should be inputting only 1 or 0. Other than these two numbers, he should not input any other number. So for that, what I can do, I can just circulate a mail saying that you should not input any other number other than 1 or 0. So this thing I can say, but apart from that, can I restrict the user? If user inputs one, so yes, you are allowed to input one. If a user inputs two, you are not allowed. Such information should be provided. So such information from planning application point of view, we cannot do, but we can give a selection to the user. Say we can give two options. Select any one of these particular options. That we can do through smart list. So for that, what I'll do is, nothing but we can go into manage smart list and do it. But before in hand, I need to create a member in your account dimension. So I'm going to create a member called tax. I'm giving a member called as tax, and after that, I'm not bothered about all these things. What I'm doing is data type. When I come to my data type, I'm going to define it as smart list. And I'll say save. Okay, so I have created a member called as tax, and I have set it as a smart list member. But before in hand, I have to create a smart list for that. I'll say manage smart list. I'll say create a smart list. When I say create a smart list, it will ask the name of this particular smart list. So for tax, name of this is smart list for tax. Let me put the same label. Okay, now display order. So in your smart list, you'll be having three columns: ID, name, label. Whether it has to display the ID or name or label, you can set any of this. So let us say name. It has to display name instead of displaying IDs. Okay, missing drop down label. If a particular cell, whatever you are tagging, if that particular cell is not having any data, so whether it has to display hash missing, or it should not display anything, or it should display some text, so that you can say. So I want to display select tax yes or no. This is what it has to display in that particular cell. So if this has to display, this means you should be saying it should not be it should not be set to data form settings, but it has to be set to drop down settings. After selecting this, come to your entries. What all selections you want? So I'll say add. Yes, for yes, id is 1 and label is also yes, and I'll say add to, I'll say no. Okay, I'll say save. So if I attach this particular smart list to that particular member, it should display in itself whether you want to apply tax, yes or no options it has to display. If I select yes, from front end you will be able to see yes, but from back end one will be logged and sent into your SBase database, because SBase is not meant for storing your text data. So one will be logged and sent. Based on the calculations, now you can write if one, calculate tax, if two, don't calculate tax. Easily you can write your calculation script, right? So but our main theme is to attach this particular thing to your account. So let me edit it after doing this. So still it is none in this, and we selecting my smart list for tax and say okay. I'll do a database refresh because this is a new account that has been created. Manage database refresh. So now this is going to be created into your SBase database. Okay, I've created this. Now if I open this form, let me add that particular tax to this particular web form for few options and say edit, go to rows and say add column tax for month April. Okay, and say save. Now let us open this account. Now if you see, still tax is not displaying you any value. It is not displaying you yes or no options. For this to be displayed, not only attaching it, we also have to perform one more activity called as evolution order. Go into this evolution order, whichever dimension is having smart list, as a smart list, select it to your right hand side and say save. Okay, you will be forgetting, most of the times you will be forgetting this option. Now let us open our web form. Now if you see, it is displaying an option called as select yes or no option. If I click on this cell, automatically you are getting yes or no option. Now user is not going to input any other number other than this yes or no. So this way you can restrict user inputting data into your web form. So clear on this. If I say save, backend it will be storing into your SBase. This is how you can use your smart list. So first you have to create your smart list, go into manage smart list, create your smart list. After creating, go to dimensions. In dimensions, for a member, add this smart list and attach that appropriate smart list. After doing that, add it to your evolution order. If you don't add it to your evolution order, it will not be displayed in your web form. For that to be displayed in your web form, you should compulsorily add it to your evolution order. So this is about your smart list. Because it is an asymmetric web form. If you want this to be applied for each and every month, what you can do? You can just say symmetrical web form. You can open a symmetrical web form. So this is how you can manage your smart list. So clear about this smart list? Just for restricting users, or just for restricting user entries, we can use this smart list. So clear about smart list? With this, your data forms are also done. Almost your data forms are also done. Okay, data forms, smart lists. Now let us, so I think manage database, currency conversion, exchange rate is also done. Up to this, all options are done. All these options are done. Creating application, if you want to create, manage only a database manager or application or provisional manager, admin will have this options: create application, delete application, register application, manage data source. You can create your data source, you can manage, you can edit your data source, or you can delete your data source. This we are not going to use. You can log into shared services. This we are not going to use. To do a database refresh, we use this. And to currency conversion, we use this. For exchange rates, we use this. So with this, we are done with this. Up to these options, we are done. And from here we are done with data forms and we are also done with smart list. So remaining things are, let us go into application settings. So when I say application settings, so application settings are nothing but mostly handled by your administrators. So this application settings, in this, every time, whenever, say for example, you are migrating your production environment to QA environment, after migrating it, first thing you have to do is log into this, come to your application settings and register the shared services, because it will be pointing to your production server. What you need to do, you need to point it to your QA production server. Only that change we need to do. After changing the link name, just say register to your shared services. When you click on register to shared services, it will ask where it has to be registered. This particular application, where it has to be registered. It has to be registered under default application group. I'll say let's get registered. Has been registered. So for this purpose, we'll be using this registration. Why this change has to be done? Mostly when you migrate your application from production to QA, in that case, it will be pointing to your production only. Instead of that, what you have to do? You have to replace this production URL with your QA URL. This is shared services URL. After doing that, you need to press on register shared services. This option you have to know. And apart from that, application maintenance mode. Right now this application is in maintenance mode. Who all can access this particular application means only your administrator can access this particular application. All users cannot access, or owner of this particular application cannot access. Only whoever role is, security roles we'll discuss later. Whoever is an administrator, he can only log into your planning application. Okay, so this is one more option that you have to see. And your owner is displayed here. Assign application owner, select user. These many users are there, you can make the other user also as the owner of this particular application. So after doing these changes, you can say on save. Nothing more than this is required in your application settings. Main thing is application maintenance mode. Whenever you want to take a backup of this particular application, what you will do? You will come here and you will set, you will not allow all users, but you will allow only administrators. Even administrator should not log in, then you will select only owner should be logging into this particular application. When you set this, only owner will be able to log into this. Okay? So let us close this. And now, so with this we are done with application settings. Now let us go into view statistics. When you select view statistics, it is nothing but in SBase, you can look number of users connected to your SBase database. Same way, number of users connected to your planning application. So how many users are connected to your planning application, that you can look from your view statistics option. For this purpose, we will be using this view statistics, nothing more than this. Okay, coming to reporting. Say for some reason, user is asking you to display what all web forms are there, and in each and every web form, what is present in columns, what is present in rows, what is present in pages, and apart from that, you also want to have information what business rules are there, and at the same time, how many users are having access on each and every web form. These related information he asked you. What you can do, you can right click, open each and every web form, and you can note it down. Instead of that, they have given you an automated process where you can create a report out of this dynamically. Say I'll say create report. So I'll select my webforms. So I want all these webforms. I'll say create report. So it will create a PDF report based on each and every webform. So now it has created a report. So after creating this particular reports, now if you can see, this is your web form act but few accounts data. So if I go into this, in columns I am having this particular accounts and this particular periods. In rows I am having these dimensions, and in pages I am having this dimension. POV I am having these dimensions, and at the same time number of users having access onto this. This is also different. Right now, we still didn't provide any access, so we are not able to see any of them. But business rules attached to it. So this way, you can generate a PDF out of your planning application. This is how it is. Each and every web form will be different. Number of users. Note, to this particular web form, who all are having access? That related information will be different. So to generate this, what you will be doing? Whichever web form you are reporting. So in reporting, I will take my required web form. Say for example, I want budget only these two things. I'll select them from my right hand side and I'll say create. This will generate a PDF. Because on quarterly activities you'll be doing this. Who all are having access to web forms, that related information you have to provide to your business. So in that case, you can directly send this particular report so that they can have a better idea on this. So this is about your reporting. And you know alias tables. Say from your 11.1.13, you can create 10 alias tables with the default. You also have a default table already created. If you want to create a new alias table, you can create your alias table. Right? Say I want to create India. So, means alias name or name should not be present in your SQL database. So, you can create your alias tables. Next. So this is about your alias tables. So remaining things are security is remaining, and we can look into copy data, clear cell details. We can look into this later, and if I want, we can explain on this manage properties. So when you go into this manage properties, you need not touch this particular manage properties. In this manage property, only one thing you will be touching is your supporting details cache. You can change it. You can change it up to 60. There is something called as supporting details. So what is this supporting details? You can change this particular supporting details cache to 60, not more than that. So to do that, let us open a web form. I have opened this particular web form. Now I want to give some information about this particular 100. I don't want to directly give 100, but I have to give some detailed description about this. So what I'll do, I'll double click on this. So if you see, supporting details is going to open. So in this, what I'll say, due to car sales, I got 50 rupees. Okay? And how I got this 50 rupees, I'll say add change. In this, due to spares, I got $25,000, let us think. And I'll select this and I'll say add sibling. Due to body sales, I got 25. Okay. Now I'll select this car and I'll say add sibling. Still remaining there is somewhere around 50 rupees that has to be inputted. So I'll say bike sales. So because of this, I'm getting this data. So I have entered 25, and in this I'm putting 50. I'll say save. So now if you see, this particular cell is 100, but you cannot directly update this 100. If you try to input numbers, it will not update. Only what you can do, you have to always give this detailed information. So you can specify user, only in this cell you have to input spares related, bodies related, and apart from that bikes related information. So this is again some detailed level of description that you can give on your cell level descriptions. This is nothing but supporting details. For this related information, you can set your caches. If you are having many such supporting details, you can have 30, 40, 50 types of, up to 60 you can have this cache. Mostly this is the line item. So So tomorrow we'll be discussing about your task list, menus, user variables, and we will also be discussing about this copy data, clear cell data. And after that we'll be discussing into security. So mostly tomorrow we'll be discussing all these activities. And apart from that, we'll also looking into business rules day after tomorrow. Day after tomorrow we'll be looking into business rules. Cache size, 60 MB, I think. 60 MB. Okay, so tomorrow we'll be discussing about this remaining things, and mostly by day after tomorrow we'll be completing this planning related contents. So remaining things are task list, menus, user variables, copy data, clear cell details, and your security, and in this tools business tools, and in this you have workflow. So altogether like 5 topics are there. Tomorrow we can complete each and every. Okay, we'll stop for today. So clear? Akkumaino? You got it? You have to practice. Only we discuss supporting details, reporting. Those are the important things. Application maintenance, only that particular. Who is maintaining this particular application right now? Whether all users can log into this application or only administrator. So tomorrow we'll do one thing. We'll like create security first, and then we'll go into remaining discussions. Task list, menus. And after security we'll talk about business rules, and after that we'll go into task list, menus, because task list, menus are dependent upon your web form, and they are also dependent upon your business rules. Task list and menus. So we'll discuss that. After completing your security, we'll complete business rules, then we'll go into your task list, menus, user variables also we can look into it.